Johnson, John Locke, Sarah Pasco, Joe Wilkinson, Sam Simmons, Susie Dent, Rachel Wiley, and your host, Jimmy Cobb.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. You're probably thinking to yourself, is this a new one or is this a repeat? Well, it's a new one. Unless, of course, you're watching a repeat, in which case, yeah, it's a repeat. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's team captain Sean Locke. Sean Locke is 55, which means if he was a woman, Countdown would have replaced him twice by now.
Right, sisters?
I don't understand.
No, because you don't have to.
That's not a feminist thing.
What's the woman's one then?
There isn't one.
What's your salute?
Is it that?
What's that one? It's that now. Sean's
women.
Invented it. It's that one.
Come on, women.
Come on, women. I don't think it's a slogan we're going to be using. And Sean's teammate, Joe Wilkinson. Joe Wilkinson, he puts the Wilkinson into the phrase, is that Joe Wilkinson taking a shit in the middle of the road?
That'll be me.
Up against them this evening, it's team captain John Richardson. John is a vegan, but what exactly does that mean? Well, it means he's boring to talk to.
That's not veganism's fault. Just in veganism's defence.
I'm 90% vegan.
90%? What's the one thing that keeps you from being vegan?
Oh, absolutely foie gras. Oh, God, with a nice milky coffee and some cheese.
Why wouldn't you want to eat cheese?
Oh, the udders and the cows and the pus and the huge swollen...
No, just have the cheese bit.
And joining John tonight, it's Sarah Pasco. Sarah is a vegan feminist. Basically, she hates sausages.
Never thought of it that way before.
Sarah, you recently went to Australia. How did you find it?
I'm so lucky. I went there for work and they flew me business class.
Ooh.
And I assume you've been in business class before. Joe, have you been in business class?
Have you? It's like the top deck of the bus.
It's so much better than everything. It's magical. They don't do a safety announcement in business class. Somebody just hands you a glass of champagne and says, your money will save you. The scary thing about flying, the horrible thing, you know, is the turbulence. In business class, you've got a little bed with a blanket and the turbulence just rocks you to sleep. And then every couple of hours, the most beautiful woman you've ever seen or smelled, she comes over, all right, she strokes your hair. She says, are you hungry? Yeah. Ah. And then she feeds you from her breast. And it tastes like Snapple. And it's the best. So to answer your question, I had a lovely time.
OK, John, when did you last feel proud? Proud of yourself?
I tell you, on the train today, I got a lovely compliment on the train up here. I walked under the sign and it said, first class rear, standard front. I'll take that. Yeah.
Sean, is there anyone you'd like to apologise to?
Yeah. The life drawing class. My thrush was playing up that day. And I had to change posture a number of times. And I was only really comfortable with the one that was facing the draft. But most of all, I'd like to apologise to my kids. Sorry to Dandelion Moonflower, Pritt Stick, and Ian.
Joe, has anything annoyed you lately?
Yeah, a few things. If they don't want you, to drink the liquid in a lava lamp, why do they make you look so tasty? And, well, basically, I had to get a passport recently as well. And I had to get a passport photo. I thought it looked really nice in it, but with these new rules and regulations, they wouldn't let me use it, so...
Do you have it with you?
Yeah, yeah. What's that? those sort of pictures only come once in a lifetime.
Okay. All right, John, have you got a mascot?
Well, now everyone's had enough of James Dyson. There's a gap in the market for a British entrepreneur in the cleaning department. So I've invented a new, a revolutionary new product in the fight against filth. And I present to you the Swiss Army broom. There we go. It comes with its own buzzer. It's fucking good at conundrums, I tell you that. So you've obviously got your basic broom for your basic brooming. Bit of cleaning up there. Aerial, so you can put a bit of magic on. But when you've finished your brooming, obviously you might have spilt a bit. So it comes with a mop. There's your mop attachment there. There's your duster there. For dusting as well, but if you're kinky, have a bit of a tickle. Clean together, that's what I'm saying. Don't make it a solo activity. This is your grabber for picking up smaller items. Pinch your boob with it, if you're kinky. I mean, basically, if you're kinky, anything can go anywhere, can't it? Shove it up there. This is a picture of Roger Federer, just to get it by the Swiss. legally. That's a tableau there with your what days your recycling goes out and your bins there. They send everyone one of these, so, you know, do stick it somewhere. On the fridge, not in a drawer where we're never going to find it again. And finally, just in case you might get burgled while you're doing your cleaning, big knife.
Swiss Army broom. Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yeah.
What have you got?
Well, I had a big think about, because on this show I've been very bad.
Yes.
And reflecting back at school, I wasn't bad at maths. And I was trying to think, what's the difference between when I was at school and here now? And the main difference is that I used to sit behind a boy that I really liked called Wesley Galvin. He had such a nice head shape and such beautiful earlobes. I think it really kind of powered me on, inspired me. So he's here, and I'm going to just sit behind him and look at the board. See if it helps me.
Is he here?
Yeah, he's here. Wesley! Hi, Wesley. You just want to sit down there on the...
He's lovely.
Was he in your year at school?
Yeah, he's had a lot of work done. And then so I think this is going to really help me. And then so if you just come out for the maths rounds, Wes, and then maybe we could go for a drink afterwards. There's a little bar just right next door. And a couple of wines back over the... Miss Eaton.
Round of applause for Wesley.
There's a lot of tension between us.
He really smells of links, doesn't he?
That's how I like him, boy.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Do you know what I've realised, right, in this day and age? Everyone's on the internet. like a motorbike, isn't it, the internet? You go into your local newsagent and there is just... you go to... I won't say the full name, W. Smiths, right? Or somewhere like that. They've got hundreds of magazines. And I think to myself, they're really specialised. I think there's money to be made out there. So I've invested money in bought a little publishing company, and I've got a roster of magazines that I'm producing. This is and it's very incredibly lucrative. I didn't realise just how much money there is in magazines. It's quite a long build-up, isn't it?
It better be funny.
Well, that's probably why I'm taking so long, cos I'm feeling a bit cocky.
Feeling a bit cocky is probably one of the magazines, is it?
Can't help it, can you?
It's a gift. It's a gift.
It's a gift. Anyway, so the first one is The Wall magazine, and that's just about bricklaying, and that comes with a free brick. And if you collect all of the all of the issue, you can build your own wall. This next magazine is very popular because there's a lot of these out there, and there wasn't a publication for them. It's called The Lapsed Catholic. There we are. And there's interview. Johnny Vegas, Roberto Baggio, Tom Cruise, Lady Gaga. And mostly it's a directory for drugs, booze, and sex, to be honest. You know, but a popular publication. Now, this magazine, this has been a massive hit, right?
Right.
Very popular. It's Busty Foster Mums. And you can have that on lower shelves. You can have that on the lower shelf because there's no nudity or anything in it. It's just lovely mums who you'd like to foster you. And then I thought, you know, there's a trend for magazines, those celebrity magazines where they point out flaws in celebrities. You know, they sort of point out cellulite and stuff like that for celebrities. I thought, let's do that, but with ordinary women. So I created... Look at the state of her magazine. And, Real Women Shamed. It's only 2 quid.
Shaw's Magazines, everyone. Joe, have you got a mascot?
Yeah. I don't know about you, but I'm fed up with the same old piñatas. Aren't you?
Yes.
Fed up with it. So, I've come up with my own range of piñatas. I've brought a few with me. This first one is my Rachel Riley piñata. having a few cans and she's thrown up. And rather than do the old boring sweets inside the piñata, I decided to put something inside that the kids can whack out, something more relevant. So in this one, it's a load of marijuana joints. More relevant to Rachel. The next one is Susie Dent. As you can see, she's holding a bicycle chain, which is her pub fight weapon of choice.
Certainly is.
And inside is a dictionary. But in good in Susie Dent fashion, it's hiding a knuckle dust. this one's you, Jimmy. the hair comes off like not the real thing. And inside is simply some teeth whitening gel for horses. Sean, here's Sean. So he's got the traditional middle finger.
Hey!
Inside Sean, there's a load of little toys and trumpets and so on. That, things that bring you joy, but they're all broken. And finally is a John piñata.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Sam Simmons! Sam has a very unique look. I like to call it fire alarm halfway through a haircut.
What, is that why I do that?
Oh, that helps. What do you like about the UK, Sam?
Tesco's. any of the self-service checkout places are really good, because what I like to do is just before you're about to pay, I'll lean down into the scanner and sometimes just give it a little kiss. Just go. Or I'll say something like, something fun, like beach people. So I'll just lean down into the scanner and go, beach people. Hoping that someone next to me, like, will go, hey, why are you doing that? And I'll go, oh, you get 25% off. And then just, I leave them with that information. It's fun. It's fun.
With Sam, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie Dent has written 14 books. Will she ever run out of ideas? Yes, after the second one. Susie, have you and Rachel ever gone on holiday together?
Yeah, we went to Dublin and we had a really good weekend.
Yeah.
Cut long story short, at the end of the night, we were looking for a late night chemist, as you do. And so we went in, couldn't find what we wanted on the shelf, so went up to the counter, and what we were looking for, what I was looking for, was a hot water bottle, because it was really, really cold. And there was no hot water bottle on the shelves. So I said, do you happen to have a hot water bottle, to the pharmacist? And he said, yeah, I do. And he leant down behind the counter and got this massive, long hot water bottle that I guess is like a bolster that you kind of put it next to you. And Rachel just looked at me and she said, yeah, Susie likes a long one. And that was it, really. That kind of summed up everything. But we had a hot night. A warm night.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Now, despite what you might think, Rachel's job isn't just putting vowels and consonants on a board. She also has to take them down again. How's your Russian coming along?
Well, I've been once and I tested it out and they understood me mostly, but I did get in a taxi and asked the driver to take me on a cruise on the fish instead of on the river, because Rika Riba, very close. But I have been very careful not to mistake blowjob and minutes, because they're very similar. Minutes is minute and blowjob's minuette. Don't get those confused.
Sounds like your Russian's going great. OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Baseball Set. Come on, Fabio, you can do this. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Sean, Joe, you get the pick of the letters.
Quibby, get me, please.
Yep.
Philip, get.
T.
Clip dorsal.
T.
Jennifer.
S.
Full.
O.
Squishy.
R.
Ping. Cousin.
F.
Hole.
And final I.
Okay, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Mortal Countdown. Ready, fight.
Bullshit. Sean, how many?
I've only got six.
Joe, how many?
Seven.
Seven? You got seven?
No, I've got four.
Four. OK. Sarah, how many have you got?
Six.
Six? OK. John?
Seven, I think.
I mean, it's not a panto. Joe, what's your four?
Tens.
Tens?
Tens. More than one ten.
Sean, your six?
France.
Oh, lovely.
OK. Sarah, your six?
Mine's feints with an E.
Feints with an E.
Like in boxing.
And John, your seven. For the points.
Forties.
Ooh. Nice.
It's like my tens.
Yeah.
OK, 7 points to John.
Good luck, John.
Good luck, John.
Could they have done any better?
A bit of softener. Great.
Oh, lovely.
Is that as good as it gets, Susie?
8 was the best. Yeah. OK.
Yeah. Pretty good. Pretty good. OK, on to our first numbers round. Sarah, your turn to pick the numbers.
Does that mean I can get my Wesley?
Yeah, you can get your Wesley.
Wesley, can you come back?
Can I ask, was Wesley a bully? Because it might hinder my...
No. He's really nice. He's sporty, but, like, not in a bad way.
Could you just point out for the viewers at home as well that his stool is higher than my chair?
Just out of interest, he's grown a proper beard as well, hasn't he?
Yes.
I wouldn't say it's a proper beard.
Okay, so we're picking the numbers, are we?
Yes.
We'll go Norm, please.
Norm. The one big.
50 or 100 would be dynamite. Not 75. I'm out if it's a 75.
5, 9, 10, 2, 4.
I'll cock and ball.
517.
Okay, 517 is your target, and your time starts now.
Christ alive. That's quite close.
So the target was 517. Sarah, did you get it?
No.
Did you get distracted by that young man?
There is a smell of links, yeah. John's right.
What did you get? How close?
Oh, I just wrote all the numbers down.
I tell you what, he's done it for me, though. Turns out a man you went to school with behind me really rocks me off.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
No.
Yeah. You did. OK, yeah. You got it. Joe, did you get it?
I think I got it, yeah.
No. Did you get 517 from those numbers?
I think I got 517, yeah.
Sean, did you get it?
No, I got 516.
OK, ooh. Joe, how did you get it?
4 + 2 = 6, times 75 = 525.
Ah.
Is it? OK, I'm out.
John.
9 - 2 = 7.
Yep. OK.
Times 75.
525.
10/5 = 2.
Yeah.
Multiplied by 4.
Hold on. Right. 10/5, what do you mean?
And then take it.
What the fuck is 10/5?
10/5.
Well, say that.
You're not allowed to divide things. I thought you could either add them and you could do times. I didn't realise we were on dividing yet. I didn't think we'd done it. We haven't done division.
Exactly.
I only even did that because I didn't want to play my joker.
Which is what?
You know the joker, you can have any number.
What?
You just swap any number.
Can you?
Yeah, so if you'd have played your joker, you could have turned the 2 into the 72 and you'd have got it.
Yeah, well, what? And the other thing is... Well, it's worth mentioning, 9's are wild in Countdown.
Oh, yeah.
Are we doing the
Joe, it's a carve-up stitch-up. They don't want us to win. It doesn't suit their agenda. Yeah, it's very convenient.
I'll give him the fucking point.
Yeah.
OK, that's 10 points to John. And here is your teaser. The words are cage nips. The clue is get them out. That's cage nips, get them out. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were cage nips. The clue was get them out. It was, of course, escaping. So, John and Sarah are in the lead. Sean, what are you reading?
Oh, it's just another one of these magazines I've got out at the moment.
What's the magazine?
Well, you know there's a lot of consumer magazines out there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Well, it's hard to know sometimes which is the right consumer magazine for you. So I've created
What Witch magazine? I mean, I've just got a growing empire. This is Tim magazine. It's just stuff about Tims. Any Tim you could think of.
I would have said it had been a quiet year for Henman, but he's still won Tim of the Year.
Yeah, yeah. He's,
you know. Who was he up against this year?
The Tim.
who came second in that?
Mallet.
Brooke Taylor.
Timmy Mallet was in there. It was Tim. Well, it's a bit of a cheat, but we've got Justin Timberlake. And then the final magazine. Now, there's money in porn, we all know that. And I thought to myself, I want to provide a service which isn't provided for. So I created this magazine, it's called Red Hot Sex. It's basically, it's people with the flu. I mean, look at the state of him. He has to do a whole coach load of sick nanas.
I didn't think you were going there with it.
So, you know, it's people with the flu having sex. What could be more fun than that?
And you managed to get Novak Djokovic.
Yeah. Well, he's a dirty bastard.
Sean's magazines, everyone.
Sean's magazines.
OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for John and Joe.
Oh, crap.
John, your turn to choose. Joe, okay. Your turn to lose.
I'll have a consonant, please.
M.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant, please.
R.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And a consonant, please.
L.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And a consonant, please.
V.
And a consonant, please.
D.
What was it?
D.
Oh, I love D.
And a final... And a final vowel, please.
Oh.
OK, and your time starts now. Susie, Rachel, are you hungry? Hang on.
Oh!
Okay, I mean.
Oh!
Okay, okay. Okay.
Yay!
Sean, are you hungry?
Go on then.
Okay. John, how many letters?
Seven.
All right, Joe, how many letters?
Yep, seven.
John, what's your seven?
Unloved.
Aww.
Well, what did you get?
Unravel.
Mm.
How did I get it? I was told.
Who told you?
Your brain told you. That's how
well,
it
you,
works.
Yeah, after you wrote it there.
We need points, Joe. Don't blow them.
Still get it.
7 points to both teams. Dictionary corner. Could they have done any better?
Unloader and overland.
Yeah.
So at the end of that, Sean and Joe have 7. John and Sarah have 24. Right, now time for Sean and Sarah to go head-to-head. Sean, your turn to pick the numbers.
OK.
Yes.
I would like one big one and 5 little ones.
They are 7, 2, 7, 9, 3 and 75.
OK, so your target is 5, 5, 5. Easy to remember if you like fives. Your time starts now.
Thank you.
keep adding. Just keep adding.
Did you get it, Sean?
No! Yeah, I did, yeah.
You got it, okay. Sarah, did you get it?
No!
Yeah, we're back in this.
Yeah.
Okay, Sean, talk me through. How did you get it?
How did I get it? 7 times 75.
7 times 75 is 525.
3 times 7 is?
3 times the other 7 is 21.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Add it on.
5, 4, 6.
And what happens if you put a 9 on that?
Yeah, 5, 5, 5!
10 points for Sean! OK, time to go across now to Dictionary Corner. Sam, what have you got for us?
I have some impressions that I've worked pretty hard on, so...
Well,
I said hard on. OK. let's go. Let's go with this first one. All right, I've really tried.
This is an impression of a man who confused going on a trip to Legoland with a leg of lamb.
Aw.
This is an impression of a man pretending to be a little old Italian nonna who doesn't know the English word for pasta colander or strainer.
You know the thing that's got all the holes in it? I don't know the word, the English word, it's got many holes. You put the pasta, and the pasta go there, and the water come away, you know, like where the spaghetti stay, the water go by.
This is an impression of a man who is secretly threatened by his own sexuality whilst trying to order a croissant in a cafe.
Yeah, mate, just get one of those fucking buttery, flaky fuckers. I don't know what you call it. You know, those fucking French stuff. I'm not going to say the word for it. Just make sure it's heaps fucking melt in the mouth. Oh, shit.
This is a man trying to order a bowl of soup.
Yeah, mate, just give us a bowl of that fucking hot, wet shit. Yeah, you know, that one over there. I don't care how hot it is, I'm just going to chuck it at my head. I'll get some in me cake. What flavours have you guys got? Oh, look, you've got a velouté of pumpkin. Oh, shit.
Here's that very same man violently chewing an apple in an overcompensating fashion, just in case anyone thought he may have any shred of femininity whatsoever.
Now, the trick to, like, eating an apple is you just attack the apple violently like it's an enemy. You just go at it like a man, like...
Sam Simmons, everyone. The scores at the moment. Sean and Joe have 17. Yeah. John and Sarah have 24. Yeah. And here is your teaser. The words are show pork. The clue is make sure you've got wood. That's show pork, make sure you've got wood. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were show pork. The clue was make sure you've got wood. It was, of course, workshop. Time for another letters round. Rachel, how many of these have you done?
20,000, I think. I've had my 10-year anniversary now, so...
10 years of shows. Well, let's celebrate. Genius, let's have a look at some of your best bits from the last 10 years. Rachel, could it be done?
Leave it with me.
What, sorry?
So leave it with me.
OK, can I just remind everyone, that is Rachel's only job, so... Rachel, could it be done?
2016.
4 25s is 100, multiplied by 5 is 500, minus 75 is 425.
4 25s is 100. Sorry. I was then.
Wowzers, I thought you were the smart one.
I just stopped listening.
Okay. Okay. Sorry.
Why isn't a 5 and a 4 coming out?
A bit more exciting for me.
If numbers.
Years on Countdown, Rachel Riley, everyone.
Just before we go on, Susie, out of interest, how many years have you been on the show?
27.
27 years. Okay, on with the game. Sean and Joe, your turn to choose the letters.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Yes, you can, Joe. S.
Another one, please.
B.
A vowel.
I.
Consonant, please.
T.
An H. Please. consonant, please.
Why do you want an H?
I want to spell shit. A consonant, please.
C.
Consonant, please, until I get eight.
Yes.
Consonant, please.
That's very silly.
I'm afraid of
it. Don't spoil the game.
I need some vowels now.
A vowel.
There's rules. There's
rules.
We can
win this, Joe.
Can we?
U and an E.
Ooh. Okay, and your time starts now. Sarah, how many letters?
Six.
Six. John, how many letters?
Seven.
Joe, how many letters?
Three.
Well done. Sean, how many letters?
Six.
Six, OK. Joe, what is your three-letter word?
Sit.
Sean, you're six?
Tribes.
Tribes. Sarah?
So the thing is, I've got six I trust, I've got an eight I don't trust. So should
go
I...
Go for the eight.
Do you reckon?
Bit of excitement. OK, John, what was your seven?
Well, you should have got this after your magazines. Bustier.
Ooh,
dirty little...
But your mind goes.
Sarah, you're eight. Your risky eight.
My risky eight, I wrote crusties, like old people.
Is it in there, Susie?
It is.
Yeah.
Crusties. OK, Sam, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah, rictuses.
What's that?
Yes, rictus grins, rictuses.
What is rictuses?
You have a rictus grimace. It's, look at Jimmy. It's a kind of fixed grin.
OK, so 8 points to Sarah. OK, time to go once again to Dictionary Corner. Sam Simmons, what have you got for us?
So it's a karaoke song about a song you'd know about fingers. Does that make sense? Let's go. They're fulfilling the things you want. Getting service in a restaurant. Or high-fiving this guy right here, yeah. Or scratching your itchy ear. They're for hailing a taxi cab. Or for picking an elbow scab. Or touching a random man here on the head. Randomly touching men with my fingers, pointing at a seagull going, fingers, help you eat a sausage roll. But mine can't play guitar. Why can't you play the guitar? They can pull apart chicken wings, point at pictures of old Beijing. You can use them to pat a cat or for pinching your belly fat.
Place a pancake on rabbit's head. I hear some Irish soda bread. You can use them to wave goodbye. Stick your fucking finger in your eye. I'm sick of pointing out all the things you can do with your fingy fings. Like these fingers with burger rings. Here's some potatoes, fingers, touching other fingers, fingers, fingering a finger. These fingers think it's a horse. Stop it, mate, I'm not doing any more.
Sam Simmons, everyone. That was lovely, and you could also hear, if you're listening closely, David Bowie turning in his grave. The scores at the moment, Sean and Joe have 17, John and Sarah have 32. And here is your final teaser. The words are lube kits. The clue is the bigger, the better. That's lube kits, the bigger, the better. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were lube kits. The clue was the bigger the better. It was, of course, bulkiest. OK, time for our final letters game. John, Sarah, your turn to choose the letters.
OK. Please.
Right, thank you very much. Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Sarah. T.
Can I have a vowel?
Can I have an A?
Can I have two consonants?
N and a L.
A vowel.
I.
Oh, it's going to spell down right.
A consonant.
P.
Another consonant.
S.
Why is this so funny? A vowel.
A.
A. Another consonant, please.
And the last one. C.
Why is this so funny?
Okay, your 30 seconds starts now. How many?
I got eight.
What now? Another eight?
Yeah.
You're killing it. John, how many?
Eight.
Joe?
Some risky five.
A risky five?
Yeah.
Sean?
I got eight.
OK, Joe, what's your five?
Oh, there's one.
Clips.
Clips. OK. Sean, what's your eight?
Capitals.
Capitals.
Very nice.
Sarah, what's your eight?
Captains.
OK, John?
I also got captains.
8 points to both teams. Very good. Sam, Susie, could they have done any better?
No, eight was best that we could do. As a medical term, aplastic as well for eight, meaning it's describing organs that don't function properly.
OK, so Sean and Joe have 25, John and Sarah have 40. 40, yeah. Pretty good, high scoring. OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. And your time starts now. Come in.
Can I go first?
Yeah.
I've just seen the word dragon in there.
Yeah. Well, you'll kick yourself, because the answer's actually pet dragon.
Oh, well played.
I'm going to restart the clock.
Can I get some points for dragon?
No.
We're restarting the clock.
Seriously not get a point for dragon?
I would... I
would love to help, but I'm going to restart the clock.
Oh, wow. Bloody seat dragon. Oh.
Danger top. what you put on if you're going on a risky sort of adventure.
It's godparent.
It's what? What was that?
Godparent. I heard Sarah say it. I thought I'd ruin it for her.
Let's see if Sarah's right.
How are you supposed to see that?
Right. Sarah, that means the final scores are Sean and Joe have 25, John and Sarah have 50. Congratulations, John and Sarah. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Baseball Set. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Streamy brand new series on All Four of Two Sisters, starring Aisling B, struggling in their comical way to survive life in This Way Up. Comedy Studio Game celebrity Danny Dyer, along with other guests, join in the late-ish show with Mo next.